The capital look is pretty much, well, anything goes. They quite enjoyed having sort of quite ethereal skin, quite high contoured, a nice sort of alien glow about themselves. But also every form of clashing colour you could possibly think of, you could wear. If you wanted to wear a blue lip with an orange lip line, you could. I think it's the most fun, most experimental makeup place you could possibly ever live in. There are many different approaches to dramatic makeup. Some people would sort of just decide to wear a sort of a liquid gold eyeliner, which, you know, the gentleman wore, like Cinna. Some of the ladies would be a little bit more austere and make themselves look quite haughty. And then some of the younger girls, you know, they have multicoloured hair and the laser-cut eyelashes. To figure out your own capital look, well, basically imagine fairy tales, Disneyland, candy floss, and apply that with some glitter. Basically glitter. Glitter and colours. Multicoloured, all the time, everywhere. My favourite brand for pigments at the moment is Makeup Forever. I like their metallics. You can mix them with a little bit of water and make them from an eyeshadow into an eyeliner or a lip liner or a lipstick. Obviously, MAC do amazing bright colours, great pigments. The Yves Saint Laurent lipsticks are very good. They have quite a creamy texture, so you've got quite bright colours, and they're not going to feel too matte on your lips, so you don't feel like you can't sort of speak or drink or eat anything. Otherwise, Rimmel do great pencils, really strong colours. Maybelline mascaras are amazing to get some really big winged eyelashes. And then Paper Self eyelashes are the ones that they use in the film, where Effie Trinket has little peacocks sticking on the side of her eyelashes, things like that. They're quite fun. Beauty blunders in the capital. Well, when you're applying strong pigments, generally if you're going to do a strong eye makeup, I would leave your skin till later. Because quite often when you're applying a pigment, it will drop down onto your cheek. And especially if you're using something like a purple, it can make you just look like you've got a black eye or really, really tired. So apply your eye makeup as you would, and then use a very soft baby wipe or a little bit of eye makeup remover just to sweep underneath, to take away any pigment that you don't want. Then you can apply your concealer or your foundation afterwards and your powder, and to give you that really clear, perfect finish.